So today I am with my granddad. Say hi, granddad.
Hello. Hello, Shunties.
So I'm filming with my granddad today, and we're going to be filming the St. Lucian tag. I'm going to be asking him a few questions today. He's never really filmed, so he's like, look, what are you looking at, granddad?
I'm looking at you.
Okay. He's looking. I don't know where he's looking, but yeah. So we're going to film this today. I've got my notepad, so if you see me looking down, I'm reading the questions. So yeah, granddad, just your honest answers for all the questions. Just yes. Be honest, and yeah. All right?
Yes.
You ready?
Yes, I'm
okay,
ready.
Okay, we are going to film now.
I'm ready, my dear. I'm from a place they call in Deriso.
Deriso, okay. What's the, what part, like, is there a capital for that?
It's a little country.
Yeah.
They call Deriso, but I was not born in, I was born in Miku village.
Mm.
But I was raised up in Deriso. It's a little country.
Yeah.
In Deriso.
Okay.
Named Deriso.
All right. So Deriso is quite small, yeah?
Well, it's a small little place, but it's still a lot of very popular place.
Okay.
I was in St. Lucia 16.
No, I mean, when was the last time you was there? Like, when was the last time you was in St. Lucia?
This year.
So my granddad goes to St. Lucia every year, guys.
Every year.
He goes every year. And you like going every year?
Yes, I would like to go every year once I could afford it.
Yeah, that's the thing. St. Lucia's expensive. Like, well, for the flight, that's expensive.
Well, I'm going to visit all my friends, visit all my friends. We go to Boogie, we go to Seaside.
Yeah.
We go Fish Night.
What's that? Can you explain what the Fish Night is?
Fish Night is a place they call Denry.
Mm-hmm.
It's plenty of activity, music,
yeah.
Plenty of people. You eat fish, lobster.
And that's in Denry, right?
No. Well, it's that. It's all through every Saturday night. It's all through the year until Lent. It stop in Lent time, which means they call it Batwa, Kawem.
Kawem.
Okay. It's called Lent. When Lent time, it stop until for a month.
Mm.
But there is plenty of activity. There is one in Anslore Fish Night. There is one they call in Groselet Day. We go there as well.
Yeah.
At Groselet Day is every Friday.
Mm, okay.
We go there every, not every day, but sometimes we go in Anslore on Saturday or January Saturday, what you call Fish Night. But they started in Miku one time, but they didn't carry it. It stopped after a while.
Okay.
Well, I was asked a question before.
The really?
Favorite dish in St. Lucia, they call it. I think they said, well, sorry to use that word. In Jamaica, they said ackee and salt is your favorite, but I think St. Lucian dish in St. Lucia, I think it's green bananas and saltfish.
Mm, yeah, that's the national dish.
That's the national dish.
Green fig is like green banana.
What we call in Padua fig.
Yeah,
green banana green fig, and saltfish. Mm-hmm. Green fig and saltfish.
Yeah, but is that your favorite food?
Well, that's not food. Like, I like sweet potato.
Mm, okay.
Right, my favorite sweet is potato. Like sweet potato. I like sweet potato, breadfruit and dashing and yellow yam.
Yeah, fried breadfruit is nice.
And yellow yam.
Mm. Okay. Any meats that you like?
Well, I eat a lot of fish. When I'm on holiday, I eat mostly fish.
Okay.
And when we go out, we eat some roast pork.
Mm.
Well, my memory lived in St. Lucia. Well, I was I can't remember, but all that I remember, every morning I used to get up and milk cow and things like that and tie cow. I was raised up in a little estate they call Candel Estate, and we had a lot of cow. We used to milk cow every morning.
You used to sell it, or?
So we used to sell the milk for a lady in Miku, they call Idoa.
Okay.
He had a little shop selling bread, milk, and cake and things like that.
Okay.
We used to sell the milk for her, bring the milk for her every morning.
Mm. So what about, because I know as well, granddad, that you went to Trinidad, didn't you?
No, when my father, after I grown up.
Okay.
After I grown up, about age of 18 to 19, I think, about 18 years of age, I went to French Guiana.
Okay. I left working there, right?
I left St. Lucia, went to French. I worked there for about a year and a half, and okay. I didn't like the place.
Oh, why?
left French Guiana, I went to Trinidad.
Why did you like French Guiana?
Well, there was not a lot of work there.
Oh, okay. So you wanted some work?
Somewhere I could, Then from Trinidad, I fly from Trinidad to London.
Mm-hmm.
And from okay. there, spent about 8-9 years in London, and then I've been going up back backwards and forth to St. Lucia after that.
Okay.
Well, nous ne parlons pas toi.
So he
le,
said.
Le me levé avec maman, mon papa, mon patois, il est capable. So moi apprend patois, but there is no patois lower high school.
So Grandad, what did you say? You said I can. What did, the first word you said? I can speak patois. So you said?
Yeah.
I speak patois.
Yeah.
Okay.
I learned the part of my parents. Mm. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So you learned patois of your parents, just listening to them.
Yeah, listen to them talking and all that. But there's no patois when you go to school. It's pure English.
Well, they teach it now, Grandad. They do teach it now.
No,
so
but not on my.
Not be, when
days.
you was young, you
when
had to learn it.
When I was growing up, there's no patois in the school.
So you had to. You just learn it from your friends and family.
From my parents.
Mm. Was it hard to learn or was it easy?
Well, I don't know because I heard them speaking, I listened, and I
pick it up.
And they were talking patois for me. Professor, don't do this. When they say professor, don't do this. Alila, Vini, come, you know, them kind of thing, and I pick it
so
up.
So you pick it up. Because when you're younger as well, Grandad, you pick things up more.
Well,
when
quicker.
You're younger, yeah, quicker, and things stay in your head more, especially languages. So,
Well, I was raised up in St. Lucia. And so I just like the country as a that's where I was born. But there's anything particular, as I said, when I go to St. Lucia, I go to the Sulphur Spring.
Yeah.
I go to have a sea bath. I go to visit my friend. We go out in the evening. We have a drink. We have.
So there's a lot to do in St. Lucia. Even though St. Lucia is a very small island, there's so much to do.
There's plenty to do. There's always on a Friday night. They're busy on a Friday night. Yeah. Always barbecue all over from
there's a lot of food
village
there.
To village you
and
get
drinks,
barbecue
isn't it, Grandad? And drinks
barbecue and drink what you call piton beer piton, like piton honeykins you know
so there's a lot
it's
to
very
do.
Popular always something to do in the island to keep you going keep you happy or you go by the sea buy fish wait for the boat to come to buy your fresh fish what they call tuna doad honeykin you know doad all these things you buy, you know, and then there's another little fish I like again. They call them, not doa, what do you call it? Balahu.
Balahu, that's my favorite fish.
That's right, that's she likes it as well. We buy it, we fry it, dry it, and we eat it, you know, we fall fish off.
Yeah.
We do barbecue, you know, boiled lobster, and all these things, you know, you're enjoying it. Listen to country and western. That's number one.
Country
but and then when there used to be a calypso and reggae.
And then they do the dance like this. They have the couple dances. So yeah, that's country western. So
and also there's another thing they got there. They call La Rose.
La Rose, yes.
And we used to, because my mother used to be Queen of La Rose and my father used to be King of La Rose. And they celebrated on the 30th of August.
Okay. And this month is all going to this Creole Heritage Month, isn't it? In October. This month.
Oh,
October,
yeah. And there's another thing they got there again. They call Creole Day.
Yeah.
But that is a very, very good fete in the island. Which means every St. Lucian is looking forward for Creole Day. Because Creole Day means what the old days, what the people used to do years and years ago. Like, I won't say slave, but it's similar to slave. What they was eating and drinking, walking, making different things. They used to eat in calabash with without spooning the hand or different, what they call boil, what they call maniku, name, English name is apostle.
Apostle.
Different thing, crab, lobster, the roast they eat, and they really is a good fete in St. Lucia for Creole Day. That's been going on for the past few years now, and La Creole Day, La Rose, that's another St. Lucian culture, La Rose. If anybody heard about La Rose, know about
La Rose. So, we are ending it here. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and like the video and share it as well. Because I wanted to do this because there's not many like St. Lucians on YouTube and doing the tag. I literally just found like 5. So my granddad's gonna end it. Are you ready, Grandad?
Right, kondisyon moun an kade yon patwa wot, moun kade tout moun, mersi pou koute, pou video a, moun evre granddaughter moun fè. Thank you very much.
Alright then, thank you for watching. Say bye, Grandad.
Bye bye, bye bye, bye bye, bye bye.